afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Lincoln Center Stage. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. My name is Sarah, I play viola, and I'm joined here at the moment by Beatrice on piano, but the others will join in a little bit. This program celebrates a wide array of female composers over many centuries, and we will begin our program in the 19th century in Europe with a piece by Fanny Mendelssohn Hensel. Now, Fanny Mendelssohn was a female pianist and composer, and she ultimately was unable to enjoy her gifts to the fullest. She had the same musical training as her brother, Felix Mendelssohn. However, their father prohibited Fanny from pursuing music as a full-time profession. And actually, in a letter that he wrote to her, he stated, "For you, music can and must be only an ornament and never the fundamental base of your existence and activity." During her entire career, Fanny Mendelssohn actually only performed live one time in 1838 at the age of 33, and it was for the premiere of her brother's Piano Concerto No. 1. And only 2 years prior to her death in 1847, she began publishing works under her own name. Previous to that, she had composed works that were published under her brother's name. And there are now over 460 works that we have found written by Fanny Mendelssohn, many of which were formerly known to be written by Felix, but they were really written by Fanny herself. So tonight, or today, this afternoon, oh my gosh, it seems very dark out. we would like to give Fanny Mendelssohn the praise and appreciation that she absolutely deserved. And we will play for you just a short piece that she wrote called Adagio for viola and piano. And she wrote it when she was only 18 years old.
next piece for you is by another prominent female composer from the 19th century. This is Clara Schumann. As the wife to Robert Schumann, friend to Felix Mendelssohn, and cohort to Johannes Brahms,
no, I just have to hold
Clara Schumann had always been heavily involved in the musical scene of 19th century Europe. Contrary to Fanny Mendelssohn, Clara Schumann's father did everything he possibly could to ensure that his daughter had a successful musical career from an early age. He taught her how to play piano, encouraged her to compose, and even managed her tours across Europe. Clara Schumann made her debut performance at the age of 9 in Leipzig, Germany, at Brahms' house, and would perform there 78 more times before her death in 1896. In every performance of hers, Clara would always play one of her own pieces to promote her compositional abilities. For any musician at the time, this was quite the feat, let alone for women. To celebrate her groundbreaking accomplishments, we will now present to you one of Clara's most celebrated works. With Mia and Barbora, we'll play for you the first movement from her piano trio in G minor.
Thank you.
I know you've already met Sarah and her beautiful solo, and Beatrice Barbora and I, but just wanted to introduce you for those of you who don't know. This is another Sarah playing violin joining us now. We move now to the United States, where Amy Beach became the first successful female composer west of the Atlantic. Beach's history is very similar to that of Fanny Mendelssohn, unfortunately, in the way that the people that were closest to her and her family, her mother and her husband, were very opposed to her musical success and tried to kind of contain it and control it for her. Although she believed herself to be first and foremost a pianist, the agreement with her husband, where he did not let her compose more than two works a year, caused her to focus on really going for the few compositions that she had a chance to write. And we're happy that she did, because we have this next piece to perform for you, which is the slow movement, the Adagio, from her piano quintet in F sharp minor. And we didn't know this piece before we started rehearsing it in the rehearsal process before boarding the ship. And since learning it, we've really fallen in love with it the same way that we have with the epic Brahms piano quintet and the Schumann quintet. We just think it's a contender right up there with those other pieces. So we're very pleased to perform for you the beautiful and passionate Adagio from her piano quintet in F sharp minor.
Thank you. genres a little bit, and our next female singer-songwriter, All-Star, comes to us from Aberdeen, Scotland. Her name is Annie Lennox, and she initially started out as a flautist in a band called Dragon's Playground after studying flute, piano, and harpsichord at the Royal Academy of Music in London. In 1992, Lennox released her debut solo album called Diva, which went on to become a commercial and critical success. We are now going to play for you one of her most popular tunes. This is Walking on Broken Glass.
Thank you.
piece for you this afternoon, and it is written by one of the most prominent R&B singers of today's age. She was born and raised in Hell's Kitchen, Manhattan, which is just a bit south of Lincoln Center. And Alicia Keys began studying classical music, actually, at the age of 7. She was a classically trained pianist, and her debut album was titled Songs in A Minor, and it does a really great job of incorporating her classical piano background with pop and jazz and R&B into this kind of mixture, soul, funk. I don't know, it's a really great album if you have never heard it before. Today, Alicia Keys has earned herself 9 Billboard Music Awards and 15 Grammy Awards. 5 of them were actually from this album, Songs in A Minor, including Best R&B Album, Best New Artist, Best R&B Song, and Song of the Year for the next piece that we are going to play for you. It is called Fallen. So we thank you so much for joining us this afternoon at Lincoln Center Stage. We have 2 more performances this evening. At 7 p.m. is the Dvorak Dumki Piano Trio, featuring Beatrice Barbora and Mia. It is a spectacular piece, and we would love to see you there. And at 9 p.m. is our La Musica Latina program, which is featuring a bunch of different Latin songs and artists, some tangos, some bossa nova. It's a really fun program that we suggest you coming to as well. And a quick note about tomorrow, we will have 3 more performances, but in addition to that, we will have a question and answer session here at 1:30 p.m., just before our matinee show at 2, in which you can ask us all sorts of questions. If you're dying to know almost anything about us, we will answer. But if you wanted to know how we got here and kind of about Lincoln Center Stage as a program, we will discuss everything with you then. And then we'll have 3 more performances tomorrow as well. So without further ado, here is our take on Fallen.